Sushmita from Miss Pink Shoes and welcome back to my channel. So before I get started with this video, I'm really sorry that I couldn't get a video up on Monday. I was actually traveling over the weekend. It was a very sudden unplanned trip, and weekends are usually where I shoot my entire week's video because I have college every day. So yeah, because of that I was unable to shoot, and I reached here Monday morning, actually Monday afternoon. So I really didn't get time to shoot, and I was feeling sick also. So I'm sorry about that, but I'll try my best to keep up with my video schedule from now on. Anyways, now getting to today's video, I'm going to be showing you guys how to do this makeup look right here. But the catch here is I'm going to be using just 5 products, and all the products are really, really affordable. So I'm also going to be mentioning the price of every single product that I'm going to be using on the screen. So this video would work perfectly if you're someone who doesn't like wearing too much makeup, or who does not want to wear too much makeup but still wants a full face of makeup. So yeah, if you'd like to know how to get this look, then please keep on watching. So I'm done with my skincare bit, and aloe vera gel is the last step that I do in my skincare routine. So that will sort of help as a primer. So I'm not going to be using a primer, and since I'm going to be using just 5 products today, I'm skipping that step and directly getting to my base. So for my base, I'm going to be using the L'Oreal Matte Mojito 12R foundation. I have been obsessed with this, and I've been using this a lot since I got it. So I've taken some on the back of my hand, and I'm directly dipping in my beauty blender, and I'm going to start dabbing it all over my face. Now the coverage that this foundation gives is just amazing, and the finish is something that I really like. That's why I'm going to be using this for my base. I'm not going to be using a concealer today because I'm just using 5 products. So this will sort of help in working as a concealer also, because the coverage is really, really good. I'm also taking this down my neck to match it with my face. So now I'm taking a little bit extra, and I'm just using my ring finger and applying it on my under eyes because I have a lot of dark circles and I could use some extra coverage there. So I'm first applying it with my ring finger, and then I'm also taking it over some spots that I have where again I can use some extra coverage. And now taking my blender, I'm just gonna dab it like twice, thrice to sort of place the product there and to not move it away. The second product that I'm going to be using is a compact, and today I'm going to be using the L'Oreal Matte Mojito Compact. This compact along with this foundation is just amazing. It works so well together, and the shades again match really well. So I love using this over this. I'm taking a round brush like this and taking the product, and I'm just patting it onto my skin. Now this product has a bit of coverage, so it's not only going to set in my makeup but also give it that extra coverage that it needs. So I don't know if you can tell on camera, but this side definitely has more coverage than this side, and it looks much more even and airbrushed, and that's what this compact does over top of this foundation. It just makes it look so seamless. The third product for today is going to be the Makeup Revolution Iconic Palette in the shade Smolder. Now this particular product has 3 products inside, so it has a bronzer, a blusher and a highlighter. So this will really help in getting a full face of makeup. So first I'm going to use the bronzer with a brush like this, and I'm going to start adding some color onto my cheeks. So I'm first applying a little onto the sides like this and taking a little on my cheekbones. So to add some color to my face and also to contour it a little. Taking it down my jawline and onto my forehead. Now taking the brush that I applied my powder with, I'm just going to take it over the contour to make it a little more soft and blend it out with my base. Now using my little finger, I'm taking the bronzer and I'm going to apply it onto my nose. Again with the same powder brush, I'm just softening that. Now using the blush that comes in the palette, I'm going to take it over my cheeks. So I'm just swirling my brush onto the blush, and I'm just swirling it on my cheeks like so. So now I'm going to take the bronzer color again on an eyeshadow brush. So this is a blending brush, and I'm going to apply it to my crease to sort of define it and to add some depth there. So first I'm applying it only on the outsides of my crease, and then whatever I have on the brush will go off on the rest of my crease. So this won't show much, but it will definitely add some dimension to your eye, and your eyes are going to look more opened up. I'm also taking it a little on my outer waterline to sort of add some depth there and to add some warmth to my eye. So now taking the blush color, a very tiny amount, and taking the highlighter over top. So it's going to be like a pinky highlighty color. I'm applying it all over my lid. Now I know this bronzer is going to be a little light for my brows, but I find them being really sparse. So I'm just going to take some and fill in the tiniest gaps that I have so that my brows don't look naked. Okay, this brush had some of my brow powder from before, so that's why my brows look a little darker than they should. Like, this had some black eyeshadow if I'm not wrong. Now using just the highlighter, I'm going to apply it to my brow bone to highlight it. And adding it a little more of the bronzer on my outer corners. Using the same highlighter, I'm going to highlight the high points of my cheeks, the bridge of my nose, and my Cupid's bow. So we got a lot done with the third product. Now moving on to the fourth one, which is going to be a mascara. And today I'm going to be using the Maybelline The Falsies mascara. So first, before I use it on my eyelashes, I'm going to open it up and take some on the back of my hand. And now using this angled brush, I'm going to use this as an eyeliner. Okay, so first layer is not very intense because I'm using a mascara. So I'm going to layer it up and do my other eye and be right back. So the eyeliner was definitely a struggle. It's much more thicker than I would want it to be. So if you don't mind using a sixth product, then do use a regular eyeliner. But now I'm going to take my mascara and use it for what it's actually supposed to be used, and that is my lashes. My lashes feel so naked right now, so I'm just going to take my mascara and add some depth and volume to it. Now coming to the last and final product, which is the lip color, and today I'm going to be using the In Color Match Me lip color, which is in the shade 403. So with that, I finished this full face of makeup using just 5 products. I really hope you guys liked it. And if you did, don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel, the link is down below. And I'll see you in my next video. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Bye!